be Christmas everywhere, in the hearts of all people, both near and afar. Christmas everywhere. Feel the love of the season wherever you are, on the small country roads lined with green mistletoe, big city streets where a thousand lights glow. Let it be Christmas everywhere. Let heavenly music fill the air. Let every heart sing, let every bell ring the story of hope and joy and peace. And let it be Christmas everywhere. Let heavenly music fill the air. Let anger and fear and hate disappear. Let there be love that lasts through the year. And let it be Christmas, Christmas everywhere. Let it be Christmas everywhere.
Sam, Merry Christmas. Thank you so much for your greeting card. I'm doing good, thank you, Sam. Did you notice the message in it? It was very thoughtful.
We look 2,000 years back for our salvation and hope. Then what about the generation before Jesus Christ? God gave messages to them through prophets to look forward to their promised Messiah for their salvation.
It is very interesting. At one point in history, time splits into two. The people born after look backwards, and the people born before that look forwards.
In the beginning, God created heaven and earth. Then he created stars, plants, trees, fish, birds, animals, and finally, human beings. The first man and woman, Adam and Eve, led a peaceful life in the Eden Garden. But one day, Satan tempted them, and they ate the forbidden fruit. It was the first disobedience, first sin, and first disassociation of human beings from their Creator.
We have sinned. We did not obey the command of our Creator.
The serpent tricked me. I never thought it was a trap.
The curse of the Lord is upon us and our descendants. How will we be forgiven? Will the Lord Himself take away our sins?
Let us travel from the Garden of Eden to a snowy village situated in the Northern Hemisphere. It is 4th century AD. Saint Nicholas, also known as Santa Claus, inspired by the teaching of Jesus Christ, is helping the poor and needy. As usual, he is busy delivering gifts to all during a Christmas season.
This Christmas will be so much fun. I heard Santa Uncle is delivering gifts to all houses.
Anna, he doesn't give gifts to naughty kids.
Hey, don't make me sad.
I'm just kidding. Santa Uncle will have gifts for all of us. He is so kind and loving. Look, it's Santa Uncle.
Yes, ho, he's coming to our house.
Merry Christmas.
Wow, he's here.
Merry Christmas. May the love and peace of our Lord shower upon this house. I have some wonderful gifts for all of you. Are you happy? Are you happy?
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh, o'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. The bells on bobtail ring, they make our spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun!
the earlier time of civilization, people moved around the world and emerged as different tribes and groups. The lineage of Hebrews continued through Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and Moses. King David, one of the prominent figures in this lineage, ruled Israel. The Book of Psalms in Holy Bible is his internal reflections and enlightenments. King David, who lived 1,000 years before Jesus Christ, was inspired by the Holy Spirit and prophesied about Jesus in the Book of Psalms.
The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I put your enemies under your feet. I will surely tell of the decree of the Lord. He said to me, Thou art my son, today I have begotten thee. Serve the Lord with fear, and rejoice with trembling. Kiss the Son, lest he be angry, and you perish in the way, when his wrath is kindled but a little. Blessed are those who put trust in him.
After the crucifixion and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, Christians underwent severe persecution by Roman Emperor. Many Christians were brutally murdered by Roman soldiers over 3 centuries. But God miraculously intervened in the life of Emperor Constantine in AD 312. And one day, violence turned into peace.
The miraculous sign changed my heart. I realized that it is not blood, but the welfare of the people an emperor shall focus on.
Does it make a change in our policy on Christians, sir?
Yes, Senator Claudius. Stop persecuting Christians. Give them their rights like any other one.
Sir, what changes do you suggest for building a welfare state?
I read the teachings of Jesus. Let us build a new Rome based on his teaching. All human beings are born free and equal in dignity and rights. All are equal before the law and are entitled without any discrimination. Freedom to all, justice to all. It will be a new Rome. It will be a new world.
The prophets who came before Jesus preached the word of God. Many of them prophesied about the promised Messiah. Prophet Isaiah, who lived 700 years before Christ, was one among them.
Rabbi, teach us about the Messiah, whom we are looking for our salvation.
Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, a virgin will be with child and bear a son, and she will call his name Emmanuel.
Emmanuel, God is with us. Will he come as a king?
For a child will be born to us, a son will be given to us, and the government will rest on his shoulders. And his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. There will be no end to the increase of his government of peace on the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and uphold it with justice and righteousness from then on and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will accomplish this.
Saint Thomas, one of the 12 disciples of Jesus Christ, reached India in AD 52. He walked through the green shores of Kerala and shared the good news, the gospel.
Whoever claims to love God yet hates a brother or sister is a liar. For whoever does not love their brother and sister whom they have seen cannot love God in whom they have not seen. Love each other.
Master, do you mean love everybody? Love the enemies also?
Yes, love your enemies and do good for those who hate you. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who abuse you. This is a message of our Lord Jesus Christ.
These are words of peace that give new hope to me.
And me also.
The the vision and the experiences of a noble Jewish youth, Daniel, endorsed the coming of Jesus Christ. Daniel lived 600 years before Christ and went through miraculous experiences and visions about the Lord.
Daniel, servant of the living God, has your God, whom you serve always, been able to deliver you from the mouth of the lions?
Daniel, we really did not think you would be able to get out of there alive. It's truly a miracle.
Yes, it is a miracle. My God sent his angel and shut the mouths of the lions so they did not destroy me, because uprightness was found in me before him, and I did no wrongdoing in his sight.
Daniel, remember when the Lord saved your friends from a burning fire?
Are you talking about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego?
Of course, who else would she be talking about? I actually remember seeing four men in the fire that day, not three, right, Daniel?
Yes, that day four men walked about in the midst of the fire without harm. Of the fourth was like the Son of God.
The prophecies, expectation, and hope about Messiah finally came to reality on a cold night in the city of Bethlehem. Mary gave birth to Jesus. Joseph and Mary wrapped infant Jesus in clothes and laid him in a manger. Three wise men from East who believed in these prophecies and was waiting for the Savior's birth was guided by a shining star to Bethlehem. Angels shared the good news with the shepherds. All of them came to the manger and adored the infant. The shepherds bowed down to him. Wise men presented gifts and worshipped him. Angels sung God's praises. This was the first Christmas, where people found hope about forgiveness of their sins, where future generations derive inspiration from, where a new message is given to the world. Love each other. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace among men with whom he is pleased. Behold, the dwelling of God is with men.
Songs that we sing and the gifts that we bring, Christmas everywhere, in what this day means and what we believe, from the sandy white beaches where blue water rolls, snow-covered mountains and valleys below. Let it be Christmas everywhere, let heavenly music fill the air, let it.
A snowman eats for breakfast?
I don't know. What?
Snowflakes.
Then what about lunch?
Iceburger.
Let every heart sing, let every bell ring, a story of hope and joy and
Santa. And last Christmas night, I saw my dad kept something under the Christmas tree. I suspect that was a trap to catch you. This year, when you come to draw my gift, don't step on anything you find suspicious.
And let it be Christmas everywhere. Let heaven lead you.
Hallelujah.
disappear. Let there be love that lasts through the year, and let it be Christmas, Christmas everywhere, Christmas everywhere.